Welcome to this brief guide on how to convert a document into a PowerPoint deck. Whilst I've made literally hundreds of PowerPoint decks over the years, instead of creating my deck from scratch inside PowerPoint, I prefer to get my initial thoughts down in a document and then copy my notes across. But today, I'm going to show you how you can take one of these documents and import it directly into PowerPoint to create your initial slides for you. Here you can see I have my document about the history of PowerPoint, I have my introduction and my bullet points that I would like to cover for it, all throughout the history of PowerPoint, thank you Wikipedia for the information, and all the way ending in my conclusion and my bullet points there as well. But if I wanted to copy this across, I would need to do a lot of copying and pasting and creating slides one by one. So instead, I'm going to take my initial document and we're going to convert it into an outline that we can import directly into PowerPoint. To do this, we want to head to the View tab in our ribbon, and we're going to select the option right at the beginning here that says Outline. This is going to open up our outline view, which looks kind of like a bullet point summary. But what you'll see is that all of the text is the same size, regardless of whether or not it's one of my titles or one of my bullet points. So I need to assign different levels to these pieces of text so that PowerPoint knows what to do with it. I have different levels ranging from level 1 all the way through to level 9, and I also have an option for body text, which we'll cover later in this video. Because this first line is going to be a title, I'm going to assign it level 1. Now you might think for the introduction that I would then assign that to level 2. However, I would like my introduction to be a title on its own slide, so I need to assign it level 1 as well. We then move on to the bullet points that will be underneath the introduction slide. In this case, I'm going to assign these to level 2. This tells PowerPoint to keep these on the same slide as the piece of text above it. And now all we need to do is go through the remaining blocks of text in our document and update them as well. But instead of doing it one by one, we can actually use another keyboard shortcut, which if you're on Windows is holding down the Control key, and if you're on Mac OS is holding down the Command key. This will give you the ability to highlight and select multiple pieces of text all at the same time. And now through the power of video editing, I'm going to speed this process up just so I've got them all selected. Now I can head back up to the top and I can select level 1, and this will update all of the titles for my slides all at the same time. Now I'm going to do the exact same process here as well, and I'm going to highlight all of my bullet points and I'm going to change them all to level 2 in one go as well. And there we go. But what if I have text that's in my document that I don't want to appear on my slides? Say for instance I have these three quotes and I only actually want to use the first two on my slide itself. I can simply select the text that I don't want to appear on my slide, head back up the top here, and I can assign it as body text. This will let PowerPoint know not to use it when it creates my slides. And now that I've got my outline basically ready to go, I can close down the outline view, which will bring me back to my standard document view. And what you'll notice is that the fonts have changed in my document as well. So everything that was assigned to level 1 has been assigned the style of heading 1. And all of my bullet points that I assigned to level 2 have now all been assigned to heading 2. And if I had used levels 3, 4, or 5, the text would match those styles as well. So if you wish, you could just assign those heading styles as opposed to using the outline view. And now that our document's complete, we want to go ahead and give it a name and save our document. Now there's something that's important to note here as well, is that if you're utilizing this on a Mac, there's one thing that you will need to change, and that's changing the format from a .docx file into a rich text format. The reason for this is that the next step that we want to do will only accept an RTF file if you're on Mac. But if you're on Windows, you can continue to use a .docx file. And with your document successfully saved, we can then head over to PowerPoint to begin the import process. To do this, we simply go to the Insert menu in our ribbon, select the drop-down arrow next to the New Slide option, and then select the option for Outline. This will open up the system file picker on your device, where you can then choose that document that we just created in Word, and then once we've chosen it, we can select the Insert option. And in just seconds, we now have a bunch of basic slides already created with our titles and our bullet points all allocated just like we'd expect. But it's pretty basic, so let's give it a quick uplift in the design department. We can head to the Design tab in our ribbon in order to do so, and select from one of the pre-existing templates that is available in Office, or just adjust our colors if we prefer to in the Office Theme option, or my personal favorite, utilizing the Design Ideas option, where we can now have some pre-made ideas based on the content of our slides. And then, once I use the power of video editing yet again to speed this process up, in just a few moments, I have a bunch of great ideas for my slides, and my deck is just about ready to go. I even have options for things like my title slides where I can actually include some video-based content, courtesy of Design Ideas. And then all that's really left for me to do is make final adjustments to the design of each of my slides, and then add in my speaker notes, which, if I've got them over in my Word document, will be super easy to find and paste over because of the fact that they'll be in that body text format option. And that is how you convert an outline of a document into a PowerPoint deck. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.